Hi, I would like to show you the work I've done on my NS panel. Whoop, 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 whoop. Okay, I love this. I will show you close up very soon. This is just a presentation. So yeah, I love the NS panel. I love this project and I can't wait to replace all my wall switches with this one. But I also have a problem, so I would like to ask you for some help. Look at the movie and the presentation and think about if you maybe can help me in some way, because I have an issue right now. I've been working for it for a long time, and this week it was like I reached some kind of limit to how much I could put into the NS panel. I reached like 60% of the memory, so I guess that shouldn't be a problem, but it's like as soon as I add a component in this stage, it doesn't boot up. Removing another component, it boots up. Adding a component and it doesn't boot, removing logging makes it boot again. So it's kind of, it's just like I'm on this limit where it doesn't, it can't handle to boot with that much components or whatever. I don't know how it works at all. I just want to know what to do to make this issue go away, because I need to scale it up a bit more. I want to be able to control more components, but right now I can't add anything, so I can't continue and finish the project. So yeah, if anyone has any advice whatsoever, I would be super happy. I put the code up on GitHub. It's in the description. So if you have time, check it out. What can I say more? The code compiles, it loads on perfectly, but then the log just stops and I lose the connection. Sometimes the connection is still there and I can upload new working code and it boots up again. And yeah, it's just stuck on the boot screen and it flashes, the screen flashes. Bam, it just flashes. Let's just check out what I've done so far. My plan is to have at least one of these in each room and I want them to look exactly the same. The only difference between the displays is the room that is stated down here. So if the panel is placed in kitchen, kitchen is the first page, and if it's in the living room is stated here instead. So the user knows that when walking up to a wall switch, they know that they can easily control the lights in the room where the panel is placed. And also easy control of global light settings. That's kind of the main purpose and the main concept of my panel. So let's go through the first page here then. We're in the kitchen, so therefore kitchen is stated here. You can change room by toggling here, and then you will get the values or the state that the lights are in each room. We're back in kitchen. I like dividing lights into ceiling lights and table lights. So in this case, if pressing here, turns ceiling lights off. You can of course also change and dim that specific group. And the same for table lights in kitchen. In this case, this is just one light. It's the kitchen sink light. On the right side, we have global light settings. So global brightness and global Kelvin. Controlling global brightness will change all the lights that are currently on to give them a new value. I like having pretty much all lights exactly the same all the time. And this is also a value that is automated in my automation system. The same thing with Kelvin. Changing this one makes all lights that are currently on a bit warmer. And of course, colder if you press down. And yeah, you can see that, of course, the lights are changing straight away here. If you, for example, I don't know, turn that off, change this one, of course this one is not affected. Okay, no, let's do that. And next time you turn it on, it will get the global live value. Okay, so that's the basic concept of the first page. You can change rooms as I showed you, and the display is automatically rewrites all the icons to the state that the lights are in. Back to kitchen, we also have this button to change from all lights mode to kind of global sound settings instead. So pressing this one controls the speaker of the room that you're currently in. So press that one. You see the speaker in the background is changed, the volume, and you can hear it. This one controls all the speakers in the entire apartment. So changing this one, maybe you hear that it's a lot of bloop, 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 bloop. Okay, very good. So if I would like to go into the bedroom, change that speaker, just do like that. Google. Vad heter medelvärde på engelska?
På engelska är det average. Något annat du vill att jag ska översätta?
Käften. This just shows the average value of all the speaker states. I had to choose something. So yeah, it's the average. We can just check out the timer that I have. So say that someone has used the kitchen wall switch to control bedroom lights, walks away. Then there's a timer. I think it's like 30 seconds, 45 seconds. And then the timer will go back to sleep. And when you open it again, you're in the kitchen and you're on the all lights setting. Okay, now it's in sleep mode. Open it again. It should have kitchen and all lights. Let's go deeper. I want to be able to control more than lights with this panel. So if you press the, for example, the kitchen button here, you will enter the kitchen room page and you will be presented with the smart things that are in that room. And a fixed thing is the vacuum cleaner. Pressing that will make the vacuum cleaner clean that specific room. And here is just a coffee brewer and my egg boiler. And we also have a coffee order page. We will look at that a bit later. And checking out the next room, we have a living room. I have a TV here, which you can turn on and you can change source. You can mute and unmute, change the volume. I have a stereo. You can turn that on and the vacuum cleaner as well. What? Oh, yeah. Going back, checking out the bedroom. I have some sweet curtains here. And yeah. They work perfectly fine, just closing, and I have an old TV in my bedroom as well that I can turn on like that. So I just want every smart device in each room to be presented when you get into the room, so you're able to control pretty much everything. Okay, entryway, I don't have anything there other than lights, so there's the vacuum cleaner. The last thing I want to show you is the dynamic features that I've done. And that's the most fun part of this panel, I think. So I want specific events that occur in the daily life to pop up on the panel and give you an opportunity to control that event, kind of. So here's an example. This is my coffee button switch. So I have an automated coffee brewer that I created myself. It fills water, and if it grinds beans into a normal coffee brewer. So before being able to make coffee, you need to confirm manually with pressing this button. So I'll do that now. Choof.
Coffee brewer is prepared for the next brew. Standard cups is set to 4.
Okay, so you get this on the kitchen panel, and you can easily just order. Instead of ordering by voice, you can just touch this one, press coffee, and then you will get that amount of cups in the coffee brewer. And just as a fun thing, you can also, oh man, I'm still slow. It's kind of a timer on this one. So I'll press this one again. Choof.
Coffee brewer is prepared for the next brew. Standard cups is set to 4.
So this, a car cube, it controls lights normally, but like 15 seconds after pressing the coffee button, it also controls the coffee cups amount of coffee. And you get some coffee cups presented on that display. So it's just a fun thing that I wanted to show you because I think it's pretty neat. I can just, while we're using the cube, show you that if I use the cube, the global setting is changed and the group settings go with it. And actually, if you drop the cube, it controls the Kelvin scale instead. So yeah, you can see that if you update things from outside, the panel is updated pretty good. Here's another dynamic event. This is my doorbell. So if someone wants to visit me, they press this thing because it's my doorbell. Get this signal and I get this dynamic button popping up. Since you press that, you heard the lock far away opening the door. So that's pretty good. So, and that dynamic thing, I can do that again. Boom. It pops up since the code is the same on each panel. It pops up on all the panels. So if you're in the sofa, you're close to the living room switch, you can just press that one. So wherever you are, maybe you're sitting in the bathroom or something, you can just press the bathroom switch and it will open the door. Perfect. I have one last dynamic event that I've done so far, and it's about the alarm. So when I come home, I have an alarm that needs to be deactivated or hell breaks loose. So I want that, I want an alarm page to pop up on the NS panel in the entryway. So I will trigger that event now, pressing or using the API. So boom, the alarm page pops up and then you enter the code like this. No, man, 2, 3, 4.
Security system inactivated.
All right, that's good. And we can just bring it up one more time because it's fun. Yeah, cool. So yeah, that's my NS panel. I have some, just pressing the time gets you into, you could use the alarm page from there as well. Boom, 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 boom. Oh man. Oh man. Okay. And I'm also using this page just when I'm doing it to upload a HMI file. Okay, so yeah, that's it. I hope you like it. I love the progress I've done so far. And I just hope maybe someone can help me, as I said, moving forward, finding the issue. Maybe I have to rewrite everything because I'm an idiot. You can't handle the thing like I've done. You just put too much code into it. But what do I know? We'll see. Hopefully you'll help me. I think we should just finish with making some coffee with one of the dynamic events that I was talking about. So, coffee button, confirm for coffee brew.
Coffee brewer is prepared for the next brew. Standard cups is set to 2.
Okay, 2 cups. See the display comes up here. 2, you could change it if you would like to, but I think we want exactly 2. Boom! Ah! Coffee's on. I need that for editing this video. We'll just finish with turning off the lights with our NS panel. Kitchen. Table lights. Ceiling lights. And I have this goddamn... I forgot those. Yeah, you know, if I hadn't had these, you know, lights to make the video look nice, it would be completely dark. So, okay, whatever. Bye.